August then, the month of August, three fantastic test matches at Edgbaston, Old Trafford, Trent Bridge. We'll start with Edgbaston. A lot of the drama before the first ball of the game. Glenn McGrath stepped on a ball, did his ankle. Were you boys on the pitch? Were you in the practice nets?
Yeah, we were on the pitch, warming up.
Celebrations?
Well, we were dead. And it was too early to celebrate.
Yeah, it's one of them ones where you, as a sportsman, you hear the old line that goes out. You never want to see another sportsman get injured. I tell you what, I was over the moon when he was on the floor.
And when the golf cart just came,
yeah,
on,
when the golf cart
don't
came
up, don't jinx it.
Yeah, there was 15 Englishmen and a Zimbabwean doing backflips on the other side of the square when Glenn McGrath was lying on the floor. You know, he got up and he went off the hospital, and the ego in Australia really cost him when. Yeah.
Because Ricky Ponting put you into bat still. I mean, we heard that changing rooms at Edgbaston are very, very close to each other. And we heard, you know, in the press box that there was a bit of ranting going on inside the Australian dressing room at the toss, or just after the toss, principally between Warne and Ponting. Did you get the sense of that?
Warne is walking between overs, shaking his head. Yeah, he come on the ninth over, and Warne is shaking his head. So we know that there's something going on, and then he bangs him over the top of his head for six. And I still believe that deer, when he put us in and we batted first, that Marcus changed the way that English people looked at playing the red cricket ball. We actually gone from defending it, leaving it, and maybe plinking it in the Nasser Hussain, Nick Knight, Mike Atherton days, to actually going to the ball.
Well, you made 90 off 102 balls, so you give it some welly. I mean, was it predetermined? Was it just how it panned out? I mean, I remember the very first ball of the game barely got through to Adam Gilchrist from Brett Lee, so it was a slow, low pudding. I mean, did you just fancy your chances?
Like I said earlier, that when we played here, I don't think we played the positive style of cricket that we wanted to play. Probably the biggest thing we took away from that. We had the meeting prior to that game saying, let's get back to how we were, you know, be more positive, let's score. We talked about three and over in those day and ages, that was the golden target almost. But going out on day one at Edgbaston, it was going to be a good pitch, and it was a big toss that we ended up getting.
Although there
have
been
right
storms,
side.
I don't know whether right, you might have been storms
hurricane
beforehand.
Like that, yeah,
hurricane, yeah.
Just
so, you know, everybody was wondering whether it would be a decent
But circuit. it was a road straight away. No pace, didn't really swing, and we could just.
And looking back, not one of your biggest England innings, would you say that 90 was one of the most important that you played in the context of the game and the series?
I think it's got the series going for us, didn't it? It was day one after losing the test match, and obviously it was an important part of the next 5 days and beyond from the rest of the series for us. But, you're still disappointed you didn't get to 100. Of course you were, but I don't look back at it now and go, that's probably one of my best innings. No, but I look at it and go, it was an important knock in what we did and what we achieved.
I think it would have sent a message as well to the Aussies, because they obviously beat us well here within 4 days. So I think, all right, we'll just go to Edgbaston and we've had a bit of a week off. Let's hit them hard again. But obviously the momentum shifted with us because of the way these boys batted. 400
and Fred had had a pretty quiet game here and suddenly started to come good. He got a couple of half centuries, 7 wickets in the game. Did you get the sense that suddenly Fred was starting to be an influence on the series as well?
I remember more with the bat in that obviously game. It felt like setting the changer and watching it. It was like a benefit match. The ball flying to the boundary every 2 minutes.
I had that partnership with him. Yeah. When, 50 partnership. And I stood at the end, obviously he was taking the strike. And the shots he was playing off people like Brett Lee and that, putting him over the pavilion, I was just stood there just laughing my head off, because you see the Aussies thinking, wow, here we go. But I think that exposed the rest of the Australian bowlers. They relied so heavily on McGrath and Warne that the other lads were having to stand up and they weren't. And that's where KP and Freddie took it away from him in that.
It was about a 40-minute period in the middle of the afternoon,
yeah,
where KP and Fred decided that they were going to hit sixes and fours and try and outdo each other. I think Fred won because he hit a Brett Lee bouncer for six one-handed. So I think he got to that position, realised it was just too fast for him, and he was flung his hand off the bat and hit the middle of his bat. And
I wanted to ask you about the slower ball to Michael Clarke as well. I mean, the game develops.
I can remember
day, end of day three, that must have been final ball of day three.
Well, it was
a slower ball to Michael Clarke.
I wouldn't say the slower ball was your greatest asset.
Fred said,
not the deliberate slower ball, Fred, anyway.
I can remember now Fred saying, yeah, he always tells the story that whenever he can see the slower ball as I was coming up. And he used to stand at slip going, no, no, no. And he says he did that on that day, but then remembered and started shouting, yes. It was, we threw everything at Michael Clarke to get Shane Warne on strike for that last two, three ball.
Yeah, I can't remember.
It was the middle of the
can
over.
You remember the conversation that you had with me at mid-off? And you said, I'm dying to get him out and blah, blah, blah. And I was, what are you going to do? And he said, I'll give him a slow boss. Go on. I didn't do anything, but you just said, right then, I'm dying to get him out. You tried, first of all, I think you said you were going to try a Yorker.
He got hit.
And then you said you were going to do a slow ball.
It's a slow ball Yorker,
yeah.
Wasn't it?
It got mixed up. It was brilliant.
It was, my asset wasn't really a slower ball, but I'd hit him a few times, yeah. Michael Clarke, in that over, basically trying to get him to fend one down to fine leg and get Warney on strike. Because I think we knew, I think even though we were 102-103, if Clarke came out, were Warne the next morning, they got a good chance of getting this because of the character, the way Warne had been performing. And it was last minute job. I mean, you see, I threw everything at them, try it, and it came off.
Oh, Stephen Harmison with a slower ball, one of the great balls.
So it's 175-8, that end of day three. At what stage did the belief just start to slightly drain away?
There was a horrible group of
Aussies.
There was a bank of about 60 Aussies sitting together in yellow shirts. And they thought it was 102 to win, 101 to win. And they counted down every run. And I think when it got to about 40.
Yeah, 40 was the point. I thought there was no panic then.
Did you bowl four wides or four byes down the leg side?
You're getting your own series mixed up.
Yeah, that was that was 2 years later, that. Yeah. Actually, it wasn't four, it was just one. That's what they're all gone. There's about three bowls since then that have gone probably as wide. At least mine bounced and only cost me one run.
Freddie bowled one, they hit the foot off and went up and over.
Through your mind then, just as you ran up to bowl at Michael Kasparovich?
Well, the ball before, I bowled that big booming full toss. And
which was nailed out to deep cover. You were there. Yeah. I mean, either 5 yards either side of you, that's four.
Oh, easy. Yeah.
But I remember Vaughan was saying, we got what us after Simon, Simon put that one down. Vaughan was saying, what are we going to do? And we had the deep point out for Brett, who took some hefty blows. And I said, do we bring everybody in? And I did say, we've got to keep them out because we won chance at Kasparovich. Just let me have one more chance at Kasparovich. I was that tired, I couldn't bowl the bouncer because it was going down the leg side. And, luckily, Garrett caught it.
Jones! Bowman! Kasparovich, the man to go, and Harmison has done a despair on the faces of the batsmen and joy for every England player on the field.
Great win, fantastic game. If that had gone the other way, that was the Ashes done, wasn't it? Game over, series done.
Staring down a barrel of a 5-0.
I don't know how you come back from 2-0.